You wanted the best and you got it. The hottest band in the land, Kiss!
What a find! What a result!
Oh, is there anything you'd like to say before we begin today?
Get up and get your grandma out of here. Pick up,
yes!
What you were talking about this year. Be mine, do the things I says to be. Do it, baby, if you feel it.
Welcome to the show, diggers. It's a new video, another lovely day out. We're going to be rocking out, of course, and digging. Today we're going to do something a little bit different with the music. We're going to be celebrating the classic live albums. So various bands, various albums. Let's see if your favourites are included in the list. Let's hopefully find some good stuff today. Well, folks, I'm going to be trying three tone today. I asked what a good setting was on a forum, and Kev Mitchell said use three tone with your gain on 69. Let's see how I've not ground balanced it yet, but let's see how good it is. He reckons it's really stable, so we'll give it a go. See how it goes. So I had a complaint from my mate Sean. He said, you've got to get a feather for that camera because I'm sick of hearing the wind buffering it. So I've pulled a little tail off one of Nux's cuddly toys and stuck that on it. Let's give it a test in a minute, see if it works. Yes, indeed, the live album, usually contractually released by the record company. Every band's put them out. And they're usually not that live. They're usually basic tapes that are tarted up in the studio. But yeah, there's been some great releases over the years. Hope your favourite's included. Corner pads, reveal all.
Hello. Most 80-81, as you can tell, right down here, right in the clod. Well, diggers, rock diggers, should we get it out together?
Let's see what this is.
Coin that is, yeah. Here we go. We have George the Fifth.
Georgie. Oh well. Not the worst. Not the worst.
19.
Dun 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 dun.
Why has your camera got pubic hair?
Well, this is the new thing. Well, Pads has found a lovely little fragment of metal. Look at this. Pewter. Medieval, probably. Post-medieval, maybe. Tudor.
Yeah, probably 1670s. Right.
Probably off a little eating bowl or something. Yeah, or a plate. Yeah.
Perfectly, you can see the shape.
Yeah. That's nice, isn't it?
It is. You can almost use it to shave your pubes.
I just found a class button. Yeah. One of these little round like cuff buttons, but I'm not sure what it is exactly. This sort of shape is usually a bombardier artillery button, I think it is. There's a bit of a line and a bit of a circle where the cannon wheel was. But it's well worn down. Nice little rocking find though. I'll take it. He's got a silver. He's got a silver. He's on quite a roll with silvers lately. What's he got? It's silver, baby. Well, what is it?
George the Fifth.
It's a little...
Sixpence.
Sixpence? Sweet. There you go. Live dig. On a live album video. Well, sort of.
1921.
George the Fifth, sixpence. Very nice. Very nice, very nice. That rocks. That rocks. There we are. There we are, folks. You saw it here. Oh, another Georgie. This time a 1921 half penny. A what? An old 50 pence. Spendable or no? No, the old big ones, yeah. Meow. Found a little car. Look at that. Little sports car. Made in China. Oh, Pads has got something. Here he is, zooming into camera. At a rate of knots. Come on, Paddy, I've only got so much film. What have we got? Ooh! A coin ball. It's a little wee half penny. A bit of a corroded one. Yeah, your guess is as good as mine. it's a cruddy one.
It's posh, isn't
it? Yeah, needs a wheel change. Hey, I got silver.
Silver's on the silver now, boy.
Florin, 1921.
Nice one.
Don't get them very often, and when they come up, they are sweet.
Yeah, look at that beauty.
1921, George the Fifth.
I've got his baby brother. Sixpence.
Oh, well, silver's up here, mate. This is good, isn't it? Going well.
Who's that? That Porsche is looking at me.
Eh?
That bush is looking at me. Half time to go and lick it.
No, it's a windbreak. It's not a bush.
Sure?
I'm pretty sure.
To
it
me,
does,
man.
It doesn't look very it doesn't look very professional, I must admit. Yeah.
It looks like the missus needs to go, she let us have Goldberg.
And now, cut! Look. Cut! Paz has got another one of these. I say another one because I found one exactly the same in the same area. So is it a buckle? Which obviously we thought it was originally, but there don't seem to be any hinge. And why would there be two in the same place? Brass, 18th, 19th century, definitely. You'd think, wouldn't you? Nice find, nice find. It rocks, Paddy. Some sort of old electrical fitting, look. Yeah. Yeah, weird. And he's got a little buckle. Sweet little buckle there. How's it going, Pads? Alright?
Not too bad.
Oh no. Oh no. He's gone into Easter mode. Oh, I knew this would happen. I knew this would happen. Oh man, I should never give him that Kinder egg. So I picked up a 3p, 1937. Don't get so many of these now, I used to get loads of them back in the day. Well, we're coming to the end of play today, but I'll finish with another silver. Bloody shilling, 1920. Nice. Look at that little beauty. 1920 shilling. So yeah, we've got a pretty good silver dig today. It's not bad for one dig, is it? I'll take that all day. It rocks. You wanna go home? Yeah. Getting hot, isn't it? Yeah. Two dead men. We've literally gone through all the fields to avoid sheep, you know? There's sheep everywhere, lambs and stuff, because of the dog. And we've walked miles, got into a perfect little field. Never been detected. And there's one sheep with its baby in there. And we've had to come all the way out again. What a start. Lex is knackered before we started, look. He's had it.
Not so knackered.
Well, Paddy's got to refuel.
Good old trusty third lung.
I'm using 4-tone today. Quite like that. Put the gain, and you stick the gain at 80. Disc up to 6. I sat off. I'm going to give that a go. It's been pretty good, this setting, so far. Let's see how we go. What you got, Pads?
I think it's kind of, but it looks like a really old one.
Ooh.
Yeah. I haven't touched it, so I'll just dig it out.
That's a big coin.
I'd say it's a button.
Yeah.
By the thickness, yeah, dandy button. But it might not be. It might not be. I think it probably is though. There's a big rusty bit on the back. Ooh, oh nice. Let's clean it up.
Three coins so far.
Yeah, it was a button. An old dandy button. Nothing to show though. Too crusty. Too crusty. Bad little finder. Half penny, it's an average sort of neck. Not too bad. Britannia's still pretty clear. George the Third. Not too bad that. That rocks, that was quite deep though. The Amphibio picked it up on 4-tone at about, I don't know, 6-7, about 7 inches I would have thought. A nice strong signal. Happy with that. Pads plugging away. He's been on the modern coins today. Quite a few have popped up. So let's talk live albums. Some that stand out for me. Iron Maiden's Live After Death, double live album from 1985. With its deluxe packaging. Really good one. AC/DC's If You Want Blood in 1978. Really good. Kiss Alive. That album pretty much broke Kiss in America. It really set them up for a good few starstruck years. They followed up with Kiss Alive 2. Decent live album as well. Judas Priest Unleashed in the East. Absolutely energy fest. Brilliant album. Probably my favourite, I would have thought, to be honest. UFO, Strangers in the Night, really good, showcasing Shankar's talents on lead guitar. Gosh, so many. Thin Lizzy, Live and Dangerous. Great album. Great album. There's been a few. What are your favourites? Oh, some worth mentioning. Saxon's The Eagle Has Landed from 1982. The Who, Live at Leeds. What a cracker that is. The Rolling Stones, Get Your Yayas Out. Really good little album. Too many to mention. Song Remains the Same, Led Zeppelin. Deep Purple's Made in Japan. Just a few that I can think of. There's been so many, and so many good ones. Crank the gain up on the Amphibio a little bit. That's why it's talking to me a little bit, but yeah, it paid off because it found that button. Here comes Trouble. You can get you a drink, you look quite hot, mate. Yeah. Hello. Oh yes. Thank you. Well, I found quite a deep relic. Nice little button. Flat button. It has quite a nice little pattern on it actually. Let's clean it up a bit. Give it a lick. You won't be able to see. And there we are, it's like a little star shape. Quite nice, never had one of them before. Quite tidy. Good one. I'm here with that. It rocks. Well done, Amphibio. That was quite deep as well. Good sort of 8 inches, I would have thought.